What the devil are you looking at?
I'm sorry?
No, I'm sorry. I'm ruined. Ruined!
How so?
It's a disaster. Who wants to see a woman wrangle wild animals who doesn't have any bloody wild animals? Come to America, they said. Come to the land of opportunity, they said. Sod you, Daddy, I said. I'm going to America to make it on the stage. I didn't want to be in the army. Ooh. Now look at me. The old git will have a field day.
I didn't really understand any of that.
I had an act. The bravest woman in the world. The animal wrangler. Watch her tame wild beasts.
And you were the woman?
Of course I was the bloody woman. Look at me. It's the stage. Grease paint. Tears. No one wants to see a man wrangling wild animals. And no one wants to see a woman wrangling nothing. Can I borrow your gun? I want to shoot myself. You see, I'm buggered.
Why?
My animals. They escaped. And now I'm buggered.
What escaped?
A priceless Ranjaniki tiger from the slopes of the Hindu Heights. A fantastic, elusive zebra from the plains of Ongo Bongo by the shores of the Limpopo. And a magnificent lion from the grasslands of Tanganyika.
Yeah, I see your problem. They're pretty hard to come by around here.
Listen, friend. Help a fellow out, would you? I'm beyond desperate. If you see any of them, will you bring them back here?
If I see a tiger or a lion or a zebra just roaming around.
Exactly. Well, I believe the zebra's up near Larnet Sod. Distinctive creature that he is. I'll make it worth your while.
All right. Madam.
It's bloody Margaret, not madam. Margaret. Mistress of fucking danger.
Kitchen. I stashed my cut there.
Go. Get out of here and never come back.
Thank you. Sure. Did she give anything? For me?
Yes.
Might I have it?
Sure. But it'll cost you. I can't be bothered. Here, take it.
Oh, thank you, Arthur. You're... Thank you. My God. What a woman. She's... This'll get her killed, for sure.
What?
Women's suffrage. Around here, they don't even like men voting. They'd bring back the monarchy, given half the chance. Progress is a dirty word in these parts. Unlike incest.
Excuse me?
I don't want to marry my cousin Matilda. I want to marry Penelope. But they're gonna... They'll kill her at one of those rallies they're holding. They've done it before. Mister, you gotta help.
No, I'm afraid I don't want no part of it.
I'll pay. My family, we've still got some money.
Fine. Just no more running around with letters.
Thank you. Come on. We better get going.
Get there in time, my true love may be shot.
If she wants to rally, you gotta let her rally.
Well, good as the cause is, I can't let her become a martyr to it. I want to marry a flesh and blood woman, not a statue in her honor.
I'm sure they know what they're doing.
There they are.
Bo, what are you doing here?
I cannot let you go through with this. Killed.
I'm prepared to die for the cause, Bo. You know that.
Do something, please.
Do what? Fight this mob?
We must begin.
They'd eat me alive.
This is no laughing matter, sir. They need protecting from certain elements. Mostly my family. Penelope, I beg you.
I'll tell you what. Your friend here can drive the wagon for us. It'll allow us to shout all the louder.
Hooray!
Sure.
Miss Calhoun, my friend here says he can drive the wagon.
Well, Olive Calhoun, normally I like to drive myself, but today I feel like a man joining us sends the right message.
Well, I ain't never been in a protest march before, madam.
Well, just treat us like the sheep. And the folks attacking us like the wolves, and I'm sure you feel right at home. Shall we go? All right, ladies. We know our song is a good one, mm-hmm. And we know our cause is a pure one.
Yes, ma'am.
Let live.
your name?
Arthur Morgan.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Not too quick and not too slow. We need them to hear our voice.
Well, they'll hear it all right.
Very good, very good. Mr. Morgan, are you an old friend of the movement?
I'm just a driver, Mrs. Calhoun. Maybe a shotgun messenger if it comes to it. I hope it won't.
Well, our message will be delivered peaceably, Mr. Morgan. You can keep your shotgun to yourself. Stay on Main Street. It's a left up here, Mr. Morgan. Look at these people. It's about to get exciting. I can feel it.
I believe you might be right.
Good day, Sheriff. I trust you'll make sure it's a peaceful assembly.
Easy.
Oh, don't give it a rest, you sorry fool. Mr. Morgan, I give you the Male of the Species.
That's a pretty dumb specimen, I grant it.
A little further, please. Stop just past the bank. This spot is fine, sir.
Ladies? Get down!
Come on! Come on!
Talk to Sergeant!
Go home! Shut your mouth!
What are you doing? The hell is going on?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is a great day for all of us. For today is the day we begin to live as equals.
Equals!
Yes, equal, sir. Fair and equal.
This is unnatural. This is nonsense.
Equal and free, just as the Founding Fathers intended.
Yeah. Yeah. Founding Fathers, not Founding Mothers, you silly old goat.
Why?
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
His philosophy dependent on biology.
What the hell are you doing here, boy?
Keep your voice down. I'm trying to listen to the speech.
Hello, darling cousin.
Don't you ever speak to me like that.
What are you doing here?
Listening. I suppose.
Go help Bo. His cousin is a moron. Stop them from ruining the speech.
You need to learn yourself some manners, cousin.
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Oh, you always was.
Bo,
a cocky little...
weren't we just leaving?
Well, who the hell is this?
Follow me, Ronnie.
What? You'll hit me?
Oh, come on.
Sir, can you not see how idiotic you are?
Come on, Bo. Let's go. Quick now.
We
gotta go before they think twice. Oh, Lord. Follow me. I know a place. It's an old battlefield no one goes to.
Go back and hear the speeches. I ain't voted before, but kind of getting hot for voting rights.
I don't know whether to take you seriously, Mr. Morgan. My cousins are my primary concern right now. If everyone knows about Penelope and me, we're dealt with. Our families, the Greys and the Braithwaites, we bury our secrets, and we bury them deep.
Your secrets and your treasure.
You know, Catherine Braithwaite's got a daughter. No one's seen her in years. She were right, you know, and Penelope said...
I ain't heard about daughters. I heard about gold.
But Yankee gold? I fear that's just a story, Mr. Morgan. I don't know.
Awful.
Nobody died. Ain't that awful.
My cousins are vindictive bastards. My brothers are vindictive bastards. My cousins are worse.
They started it.
I know, but...
You should leave.
I will. As soon as I have enough money, when my family... We have money, but I don't.
Is your family very rich?
Yes. Well, I believe so. But, they keep me out of the discussions. I have more of a... artistic temperament, so...
Oh, is that what they call it?
Yes. Oh, you made a joke. Mm. I really love her. I do.
Well, stick around. Maybe you can die for her as well.
I thought you were trying to make me feel better.
Look, I gotta go.
Me too. Oh, damn! I'm gonna be late. My uncle is quite as bad as you would imagine. Here, your payment. Thank you. Excuse me.
you want.
You okay?
Do I look okay?
No. You look awful.
Awful. Look at me. Useless.
I wasn't born to this. I didn't deserve this. I used to be a gentleman.
Jeremiah Compson. Compson's stead.
Good for you. If that's anything to boast about.
They took everything from me.
Who did?
They.
And what did they take?
My whole life. A whole way of living, a career.
I stole a lot of things, but that's quite a lot to steal.
Look at me here, living in the shit and the mud.
I'm sorry.
My old house. The house my grandfather built. It's all dilapidated and destroyed. Repossessed by the bank.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I was supposed to live a different life.
Me too.
If only I could get my old things back. Personal mementos. A watch. Old pistol. My ledger.
Where's this house again?
Compson's stead. North of Scarlet Meadows. Bank says I can't go near it. I'm living rough over by Harris Field.
Well, if I'm ever out that way, I'll see what I can do.
Time. Time is hell.
Hey, mister.
Mister?
Of course, and here is my dear friend, Arthur Callahan. Boy is a hunter. Boy is a killer. Arthur, you've met but not been introduced to Mr. Oh, I'm so sorry, Sheriff.
Well, how are you doing, sir?
I'm fine.
Tough business you boys had.
We did?
Oh, there's no need to pretend with me, sir. Life can be tough.
So it can.
And no man owes another anything.
No, sir.
But still, I feel you were hard done by. Losing your employment like that. But still, here in Rhodes, we have work enough for honest men.
That's some strong stuff. Still, don't seem to be doing you any harm, I guess.
Exactly. Whoa. Excuse me a moment.
I told you we was moving up in this world. Deputies.
You have finally lost your mind.
Amongst these drunkards, hillbillies, and slavers? Good, honest thieves like us. We're bound to be moralizers in a place like this. Oh! Sheriff Gray, you are back.
Now listen, sir. There is shine in them woods, though, and it is costing this county its good name and the state a whole lot of income. You boys wouldn't mind rooting it out. Maybe we'll make you permanent. I gotta set me down a second.
Not a problem, sir. Not a problem at all. You are in safe hands now. And people waste time with the temperance movement. Liquor never dulled a good man's senses. Arthur, you ride with the deputy. Bill and I will follow.
Climb on up. Let's go.
Archibald?
How are you?
Pretty good.
And your friend is behaving himself?
Oh, yes. I think he's learned his lesson.
Congratulations. congratulations on becoming a temporarily deputized citizen of Scarlet Meadows County. Most towns just get bounty hunters to do their dirty work these days, but Sheriff Gray believes the law should keep the law. Now, I'm sure I don't need to remind you there's a chain of command here.
There is?
Dang straight there is. This is a dangerous business, but follow my lead and you'll be just fine.
Sure. Hey! Archibald wants to remind us he's in charge here.
Of course!
Who else would be?
You were a big help with them Anderson boys, and I put in a very good word with the sheriff on your behalf.
We appreciate that.
We rounded up the others soon after. I'm pushing for the rope myself, but that's by the by.
So, these moonshiners?
Not just any moonshiners. Braithwaites. I told you about the Braithwaites.
Pretty sure you did.
Old Cotton family had a fortune at one point until, well, a few changes in the labor laws. Now they're dealing in moonshine. We found their stills hidden all over Lemoyne. Quick as we destroy one, another one pops up. You could call it a pitiful fall from grace, if they had any grace to start with.
I have no time for tax dodgers.
Not to mention the fact that Catherine Braithwaite has a rather expensive interest in thoroughbred horses to maintain.
But I heard something about it being gold these families were fighting over.
Well, that's the rumor. But the Grays and the Braithwaites think the other stole a fortune from them. But it happened so long ago, I don't know for sure if it's true.
Must be tough being rich, huh?
So I imagine.
That bed rather suits you, Mr. W.
Yes, I thought so too.
Does it feel good to be back at it, serving your country?
I wouldn't go that far.
Don't look good. Oh.
Come on, mister.
Keep your eyes open.
These damn flies. I swear they got it in for me.
You could try washing once in a while.
No. This must have happened recently.
Hey, come have a look at this.
Look, suit and tie, one bullet clean through the forehead. Well, my money says this is the handiwork of a gang called the Lemoyne Raiders.
Yeah, I've run into them.
Let's see if we've got any identification. Okay, we should get going. I'll send someone over here later to clean this up. Would you mind taking the reins? I want to have a look at these papers.
Sure.
I'll direct you. Okay. Frederick Mitchell, Lemoyne State Legislator. Poor feller. Yes, this certainly smacks of the Raiders to me. Bunch of ex-army Free Staters without an ounce of respect for the law. That's 7 government officials they've murdered this year alone.
Yep. Not the nicest fellers in my experience.
Go right at the crossroads.
Oh, and I know the Braithwaites are in business with them. No shame. Trash begets trash, my Uncle Reginald used to say.
Bear right again here.
He had a few stories, let me tell you. Town preacher and town sheriff. Would drink a sailor under the table before breakfast. He had one tiny hand, like a child's, on the end of a grown man's arm. But anyway, this tells you what kind of people the Braithwaites are, selling moonshine to murderers. I tell folks don't even speak to them. Don't even look them in the eye.
I'm sure I wouldn't.
Here we are. So what was I saying?
Something about the Braithwaites, I think.
Even saying that word makes me sick. Now, anyone we find here, we bring in alive, understood? Round them up and take this operation down for good. Come on. Let's see what we're dealing with. See? What did I tell you, boys? What did I say? I said this place was crawling with vermin, and we just found ourselves the rat's nest par excellence, as they say in Paris. My aunt, she went to Paris back in 78.
How would you handle this?
Well, the way I said...
Actually, let my friend here decide. He doesn't have your fine way with words, but he is definitely the man for the job.
Let's split up. Arthur and Bill, me and Archibald. You boys want right or left? We'll take the left.
Let's stop these filthy, degenerate tax dodgers. The chicken.
A fine idea. Remember what he said. We need them alive. Let's just knock them out and tie them up.
Got it, Deputy Williamson.
By the bridge over there. I'll tie this bastard up. I think there's another one by the still.
That's it. Well, what do we do now?
We better destroy all this. Any of your boys can handle explosives?
Sure. Anyone but him.
Oh, so. Think you're real funny, don't you?
Tell me about that.
That is the last time I'll mention it, I swear.
like we failed to destroy the last of the moonshine.
Sure.
Would you like us to?
Well, I normally take it for personal consumption. It's sort of part of the job. But I better get back home. Why don't I just take a jug or two and leave you boys the rest to show that there's no hard feelings on account of the war?
We are all Americans.
Of course. My cousin, Webster, he used to say some of us is not as American as others, if you know what I mean. Only I didn't quite. Come on, you degenerate, no-good, white trash, hillbilly piece of scum. I know you, Billy Lime.
Finally.
You've always been a
Finally.
Piece of crap. Come on, move it.
We have a life on a land so stupid, a backwater so backwards that even we are like geniuses. Bill, get this stuff out of here. Come on. You ride with me.
Okay.
Sure, he can find a use for it. Bit of trouble back there, Arthur?
Ain't there always? From what they was yelling, I think they were the buyers.
Old Archibald didn't ask too many questions, so neither should we.
I ain't planning to.
That was worth the effort, though. Deputized and hiding in plain sight. These lawmen, these two families. I mean, I really think we can play this from all sides. Got Hosea written all over it.
This is starting to sound like the Young Dutch again.
What do you mean, Young Dutch? I'm as strong as I have ever been. Hey, you know what? Why don't I race you back?
Okay, you're on.
That's the spirit. Okay, on my word. Set. So good at running away, Arthur.
Well, I never knew age had slowed you down quite so much.
Well, time is a bastard. When you get to be my age, well, you'll know that better than anything. Be well. I had fun with you today. You're, I was gonna say you're like a son to me.